today is going to be why school lunches should be healthier in schools. And my name is Tyler Davis. Healthy lunches, school systems today are the most important for future generations of children coming into the working world. Scientists have discovered that if children eat healthy throughout the day, they will excel in their academics. Not only is it important that we see our children excel in their academics, but also as healthy as physically possible. It's also a fact too that immune systems will improve if you eat healthier. So, and that'll keep students from missing so much school. Need for healthier lunches. At least one in three children in school are overweight and obese. Children are not getting their daily recommended bags of fruits, vegetables, whole grains, low fat dairy products, and protein. The food in school today is full of high sodium, high sugar, and high fat. Three ways we can help: adding more education in school systems, healthier eating, implementing school gardens, and connecting with local farmers. Right here is a chart that I got online. It only goes to 2008, but this kind of shows you, from as a college graduate all the way down to less than high school, of the obesity rate among children, boys and girls. Nutritional education in school systems. Implementing a classroom where they teach you about nutrition can really help out. Kids can learn how to prepare healthy meals. They can bring knowledge home and make healthier meals at home. They can also learn like proper etiquette for dieting and just helpful things all in all about vitamins, minerals, proteins, what you should eat, what you shouldn't. Implementing school gardens, students can, if you implement a garden into your schools, students can learn how to properly plant gardens. They can learn the benefits of eating what they plant. Most kids will learn better doing hands-on activities. I know I did growing up. It was a lot better for me. They can use what they grow in their daily lunches at school, which will save school money in the end. Connect local farmers to school. If you do this, it'll not only help the economy, but it'll help maybe keep the cost down of the lunch price because you're buying locally, they make a good deal. Fresh produce can help lower high levels tremendously of obesity. You're helping your children as well as supporting local economy. These processed foods will contain more, less processed foods will actually contain more vitamins and minerals rather than the bags of broccoli or anything like that they get from a plant. Positive outcomes of healthier lunches: it improves the child's health tremendously. Higher immune systems, I mean, students won't miss as much class. More knowledge on how to eat healthy. It'll increase the local community by buying fresh produce locally, and the obesity rate will decline. Negative outcomes: this could lead to higher rates of obesity. Little knowledge on actually how to be truly healthy, how to eat right, and the proper vitamins, minerals, carbs, and everything that you should take in. It wouldn't give support to local farmers, which could lower your community economy, decline in overall health. Contrast, serving unhealthy meals in a school system could lead to steady decrease in school children's health. By implementing healthier meals and teaching our kids about the benefits of eating healthy could lead to a drop in the overall obesity rate in the world today. Inclusion and action planning. Inclusion and implementing healthier meals in school systems will improve children's health tremendously by educating students, teaching students how to garden, and involving local farmers with daily lunches served. Children, we can improve statistics of obesity in America.